to call in Miss our first storyteller for today is Miss Dolly Tabigne. She's a domestic worker from Philippines. She works in Singapore for 7 years. She counts on support from her family and her partner. Julianne is a team leader of nonprofit organization Uplifters and a member of Migrant Writers of Singapore. Let's hear from Julie.
Hello, good afternoon, everyone. And I will start my story with this quote. I found it in Pinterest. Family is the people in your life who want you in theirs, the ones who accept for who you are and love you no matter what, and would do anything to see you smile. Hi, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Julie, a foreign domestic worker here in Singapore. I grew up in a beautiful island in the Philippines where fishing is the main source of living. My father is a fisherman and was only renting a boat. My mother is a plain housewife, though sometimes she do some sidelines to lessen our financial burden. I have 5 siblings, and one of my sister went back home to heaven when she was just 6 years old. Being the eldest in the family, I witnessed my parents' difficulties caused by poverty. I felt a sting of pain when I saw my father's sunburned skin and a cut of nylon on his hand.
Are you able to go into
the mother aged more than her actual age when she struggled to make the money fit into our everyday needs. Because I was still studying at that time, I promised to myself that when I grow older and become stronger, I will help them with their financial problem. In that way, I can reciprocate the sacrifices they made for us, their children. Actually, it wasn't my dream to work abroad, not until I became a mother. Because I want to give my son a brighter future, my fear whispered onto my ears to stop, but my determination pushed me through. It was 7th June 2013 when I first laid my own eyes the beauty of Singapore. I was mesmerized by the tall buildings, the trees inside the airport. It's all new and exciting. A mixed emotion of anxiety and happiness, especially when I saw the people walking in front of me. I was awed by their beauty and their color. But when I look at my reflection in the glass door, scared, but remain rooted to my purpose of being away from my son. After a year, my own family doesn't work out. We are not in the same page in life. I am behind his priority. So I decided to go back to my family, whom I'm longing for their love and care. Without hesitation, they accepted me without being asked what happened. Some people in his place look at me with disgust, like I have an incurable disease in their eyes. Yet, it didn't shake me, because I know my own story. I know my reasons. Their actions became my source of inspiration and strength to battle off in life. My side remained silent or muted until this time, because I believe that the truth will reveal and unfold on its perfect time. I pursue my long overdue promise to my parents. I started to save my salary. And I was the happiest when I saw my father's smile until his eyes, when I bought his longtime dream, and that was a motorboat. My family's Bahay Kubo reconstructed into something that they were comfortable to live with. even it's raining or typhoon seasons, and make me worry less. Last month, I just bought a small piece of land, which we will develop into a small business for my retirement one day. The journey is not easy, especially when I'm starting. I experienced to bring a bread with kaya spread and a bottle of water and seated in one corner, waiting for my curfew to go back and work again. It was a celebration for me when I have $7 to treat myself a meal in Jollibee. I am doing this not to pity myself, but to save until my goals were achieved. Now, I am slowly breathing with ease because I can see some changes in my family's way of living. But the most important thing for us is to remain humble. All thanks to God for giving me the courage of pursuing my dreams for my family. Without his gift of wisdom and his guidance, I don't know where I am today. I still want to do something for my parents, and that is to bring them here in Singapore one day and experience the beauty which made me fall in love. And it became the bridge of my dreams, of course. I want to secure my son's future, which always my top priority. Success is still far beyond. However, when I see my parents smile and how proud they are, it gives me assurance that I am going the right path. Thank you so much for patiently listening to my story. Have a good day, everyone. Thank you so much, Open Borders, for giving me a chance to share some fragment of my life, which made me who become I am today. God bless us all, and love, love, love. Sorry, I'm becoming emotional.
Thank you so much, Julie. Thank you so much for sharing your story. Again, your story is actually one of the behind untold story of migrants here in Singapore. Not just in Singapore, but all over overseas, you know. This is one of the struggles. You know, we came here all for our family, and I love the fact that everyone has his own weakness and everyone has his own strength. But some people don't realize yet what is their strength until they need to be strong on every circumstances, you know? Like, if you got no one to lean on, you got no one to help on you, no one to help you, but only yourself. So I'm so proud of you, and I hope one day you can bring your parents here in Singapore and let them see the Merlion.
Yeah. Yeah. Please, thank you so much.